Welcome to the fourth of the five-part video series on A to Z PowerPoint tips, tricks, and hacks. I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations.
P is for pen tool. Do you know that PowerPoint allows you to use the slideshow mode as a virtual whiteboard so you can write on it, draw on it to explain your points? What this means is you don't necessarily have to use just a mouse. You can use even a pen tablet to write your information on your slides. Let me show you how the pen tool works in the slideshow mode of PowerPoint. Here I am in the slideshow mode. If you go to the bottom left, you get this option for pen. When you click on that, you can see that we have three options here. One is for laser pointer, second is for pen, and the third one is for highlighter. Now, to access the pen, you can click on pen, and now you can draw on the slide as if this is a whiteboard for you. Once you've drawn something, you can go once again to the same tool and you can use the eraser to erase the portions that you've already drawn. I can even change the pen color. I can go to the same tool again and I can choose any of these colors for my pen. Let us say I want to use this purple color, and I can see that this is the color of the pen now. There are a couple of other cool options available for you in the slideshow mode where you can use your mouse cursor as your laser pointer. For that, once again, you go to the same tool here and click on laser pointer. Now you can see that your mouse is now your laser pointer. You can always draw the viewer's attention to any part of your slide. Another way you can impress your audience is to use your mouse cursor as your highlighter. Once again, let me go to the same option and click on highlighter. And if I want to highlight just one part here, like say pen, I can use this like this and I can draw the viewer's attention. This can come in quite handy, especially when you have a quote on your slide and you want to highlight certain words on the quote. You can of course always change the color of the highlighter by choosing any of the different options here. Can you see? I can use a different color.
Once you finish drawing in the slideshow mode, you can hit the escape button. PowerPoint will ask you if you want to keep the annotations. When you say keep, the drawings become part of your presentation and you can save your slide deck just as you would save any other presentation.
So the next time you make a live presentation, impress your audience with these wonderful tools like laser pointer, pen, and highlighter.
Q is for quick access toolbar. Do you know that PowerPoint makes it easy for you to access any tool on your PowerPoint ribbon by placing it right above the ribbon? Let me show you how this smart time saver option works.
Now what you see here is PowerPoint ribbon. What you see on top of the ribbon is this strip called as Quick Access Toolbar. The tools and buttons that you see here on this strip are totally customizable. Let us say I use animation pane quite regularly. Instead of going to the animations tab and then accessing animation pane here, I can have this moved on to the Quick Access Toolbar. All I need to do is to right click here and click on add to Quick Access Toolbar. And instantly I have this animation pane icon available. When I click on it, I can open the animation pane in an instant. You can even customize the quick access toolbar to your specific requirements. All you need to do for that is go to this option here for customize quick access toolbar, click on the drop-down menu and go to more commands. And here you have a whole bunch of commands that you can place on your quick access toolbar. If you want to have even more options, you can click on the drop-down menu here and go to all commands and you will get even more tools available which you can place on the quick access toolbar. Once you add all your frequently used tools to your quick access toolbar, you can adjust their position by using the buttons here. If you want to move the tool up or down, you can click on these buttons. If you want to remove a particular tool, you can click on this one and it will remove the tool from your quick access toolbar. Of course, at any point you want to declutter your quick access toolbar, you can go to any specific tool that you don't normally use, right click and say remove from quick access toolbar, and that tool will be removed.
Creating and organizing your quick access toolbar can be a big time saver, especially if you are a frequent user of PowerPoint. I've already created a separate video that shows you how to use quick access toolbar in a smart way. The link is in the iCard here. By the way, if you like a more organized and methodical training of PowerPoint, please check our PowerPoint Foundation course. This complete course on PowerPoint will help you make beautiful slides easily.
R is for remove animation in one go. Let's say you have an animated presentation that looks like this. As you can see, there are quite a few elements that are animated, and these animations definitely add value to your presentation. But then there is a problem that you have now. Your boss says in this meeting, you cannot have animated slides. Now to present these slides, you have two options. One way is to make a copy of the slide deck. Then you go to animations and open the animation pane and you start deleting all the animations one slide after another. After all, you don't want to lose all the work you've invested in creating these animations. The second way is a much smarter way. There, you can switch on and switch off animations with just the click of a button. Let me show you where that button lies and how you can use it to turn your animations on and off. All you need to do is to go to this tab called Slideshow. Go to Setup Slideshow. And here in this dialog box, you get this option called Show Without Animation. You check that and say OK. Now, when you go to the slideshow, let us go to the first slide, and when you go here, you can see that there is no more animation on this slide. I can click and go to the next slide and to the next slide. Now let us say I have a different meeting where I need to present the same set of slides, but this time I need to use animation. All I need to do is to go to the same slideshow tab, go to setup slideshow and uncheck that option and say OK. Now when I go to the first slide, you can see that the animation plays and exactly the way that you have planned the animation to play. So that is how you use this option called remove animation in one go using the slideshow tab. S is for using symbols as bullet points. Most of us use standard bullet points like the ones that you see here. Do you know you can customize these bullet points to match the information being presented? Let me show you how you do it. Let me hit escape. First, let me select this list. Then go to this bullet option from paragraph. When I click on the drop-down menu, you can see that there are other options to use as bullet points. Now, what if I want to choose even more options? I can click on this option called bullets and numbering. And here in this dialog box, I have this option called customize. Let me click on that option. And that takes me to this dialog box, which gives me a whole bunch of symbols to choose from. Let us say my presentation is about 5 dangerous things to avoid on the shop floor. I can go to the symbols option here by clicking on the font drop-down, and let me choose the options under wingdings. I have quite a few interesting options here. Can you see here, these are all the symbols I can use. And here I can see the danger symbol. Let me select that and say OK. Now I have that as an option to choose as bullet points. If I want to increase the size of these bullet points, I can always go here and increase the size. Let us say I want to have this around 150%. I can hit enter. And now you can see, instead of the standard bullet points, I have these symbols serving as bullet points. The same way, I can go to the symbols by going to the same option that I mentioned before. And this time I want to give 5 time saving tips. I can go to this symbol here and say OK, and say OK again. Now you can see I have these sand clock symbols that are far more appropriate for the subject being discussed.
So the next time you want to create a list, spice it up by customizing your bullet points using symbols.
T is for adjusting transparency of pictures in PowerPoint. Here we have a picture on our slide and we want to increase the transparency of the picture so it blends quite nicely with the design. How do we do it? It's very simple. You select the picture, you go to picture format, and here there is an option called transparency. You click on it and you can choose from any of these presets. Let us say I want to have the design in the background to show through a bit. I can use this option where the transparency is 15%. And if I go further, I can increase the percentage a bit more. If you want a precise number for your transparency, you can go to picture transparency options and you can define the exact percentage of transparency you want.
Picture transparency is an option that is available only in the recent versions of PowerPoint. But what if you don't have the recent version, but you still want to adjust the transparency of your images?
A simple workaround is to go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle that matches the dimension of your picture. Then move this aside, select this image, right click and cut it. Then place this one where you had the previous one. and then go to fill option. You can do that by right clicking and going to format shape option. Here you have fill. Now you can choose picture or texture fill. Now since you have cut the image already, it is available now as part of the clipboard. You can click on clipboard. Now you have this rectangle which has the picture inside it. Now what that allows you to do is to select this rectangle. Now you can always increase the transparency to any precise point as you want.
So take your slide design to the next level by adding picture transparency to your images. So did you like the tips? Want even more PowerPoint tips? We have already made a handy playlist of all the useful PowerPoint tips in this 5-part video series right here. You just need to click on this link to start watching the PowerPoint tips right from the first one. Go ahead and explore those tips and you will soon be called the PowerPoint champ in your organization.